as we look at the start list for the ball final. So straight on to the ball final, as you can hear. Polina Berezina from Spain leading the way. Qualified fourth. We'll be hoping to go up one place to get on that podium. Music from Marvel Studios, Shang-Chi. Well, it wasn't the performance that she would have been hoping for and will have visualised. Such a shame. Lost the apparatus a couple of times. And so, so hard to stay controlled throughout the rest of the performance when you have that disappointment. But they train for that. They are used to it. It's so easy to drop the apparatus and... They still obviously get judged on the rest of the performance, so really important that you excel. Beautiful ring movement, but there you can see just his fractions, isn't it, between a really strong performance and just missing the apparatus. Well, so the score was 29.70, but I think you can see from the expression on her face it's not going to be up there. 25.450. Big disappointment after finishing fourth yesterday and would no doubt have been hoping to go up just one place, or at least one place to on the podium. Now another chance to see Sumir Kita, qualified fifth, 21 years of age. Music is Viva. When you go around me, I can feel the rest of our I do love music where it gets the crowds going, and that certainly did. I thought it really suited her. Important with the ball, if you're maybe watching this for the first time, having seen rhythmic gymnastics at the Olympic Games last year and like to start to follow it. Important with the ball that they don't grasp it or squeeze it. It should really sort of balance on the hand and not on the forearm. Lovely coverage of the floor. Those split leaps. Again, such exquisite arm positions, which I always love when I'm watching her. Apparatus can be any colour, and often it's the colour to match those beautiful, beautiful leotards that they wear. Well, I don't think she'd be able to quite do that routine with that ball. That would be a challenge, wouldn't it? This mascot has so much, not to say for himself, but so much. He's really there for all of them, which is actually really nice to see. 30.350. So that's quite an improvement on her 29.650 in qualifications. Deep breaths. The coach can do no more. The coach just has to stand and watch, and that's often the most difficult thing. Ekaterina Vedeneva. Slovenia. Qualified 7th. Winner takes it all. So elegant, lovely extension in her feet. The winner takes it all, and the music to the words. The judges will decide, well, they certainly will. But a really lovely performance to watch. Such poise there. I want to talk about the things we've come through. Nice hold. Now it's hurting me. Now it's history. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say.
no more race to play. The judges will decide.
She really looked like she put her heart and soul into that performance. Qualified 7th, 29.550. Finished 16th in the all-around at the Olympic Games, 31.150. So very big improvement for her, puts her in first place at the moment. Like take a deep breath, and then it's showtime as they walk out here. Takmina Ikromova from Uzbekistan. Music, Seven Nation Army.
I'm gonna fight them all. A Seven Nation Army couldn't hold me back. They're gonna rip it off, taking their time right behind my back. And I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget.
Well, that was hard for her, making that little error right at the very, very beginning. But gosh, did she pull it back then. So, so hard to lose the ball and then carry on, as I've said before. But, well, congratulations for her, to her for managing to do that. Finished in third place in the qualifications. Score then 30.00. So a disappointing start for her. But lovely stag leap there. You can see there just.
I'm gonna fight them all.
But the balance here. The extension.
They're gonna rip it off. Taking their time right behind my back. And I'm talking to myself.
Lovely on the split leaps. We await her scores. Finished fourth in this event at the World Cup in Tashkent earlier this year, having qualified first. 29.650, so just slightly less than she got in the qualifiers, and that's enough to put her in third place at the moment.
Bulgaria.
So another chance to see Stiliana Nikolova. Sounds like she's already a crowd favourite from Bulgaria, the 16-year-old. Already a silver medalist from today in the hoops. Wow, and you can see why the crowd love her as much as they do. Music to beauty never lies. What an abundance of confidence that she has. And you can see that she truly, truly loves competing. Finished second in this event back at the World Challenge Cup earlier in May. Her score then was 32.60. Only just qualified in 8th place with 29.350 at this World Cup. But she's all smiles. She just makes me want to smile as well. She is just so beautiful to watch, but incredibly talented as well, with good difficulty, strong execution. So, so flexible, wow, as all of these gymnasts are. Beautiful. Does that ring so well? Head touching her leg there. She has so much confidence. She is an absolute delight to watch. Fairly new to the international stage. She's only 16 years of age. But gosh, what a talent now and for the future. 30.60. And I think that's good enough at the moment to put her into second place. Ekaterina Bedeneva, currently lying first. Samir Fukita from Japan, second. And the crowds will go wild again. Milena Baldassari from Italy. Qualified in 6th place. And on every floor and Well, the crowd loved it. Music, the Trapper and the Fourier for the 20-year-old from Ravenna. Competing or started with rhythmic gymnastics, age 5. She says that she loves to express herself to the audience, and I think that really came across during that performance. She was also the first Italian rhythmic gymnast to win at least a silver medal in an individual event at the World Championships back in 2018 when she got a silver in the ribbon. And I'm surprised, I would imagine she really made a lot of inspiring gymnasts take up rhythmic gymnastics as a result of that World Championship medal. Aiming for the Olympics 2024, and then wants to continue to work within the sport. As you can see, it wasn't a perfect performance. Received the Alina Kabeva Award when the World Championships were held in Pesaro, actually, back in 2017. Well, lots of love hearts for the audience. How nice. 29.550 was what she scored in qualifying. So it sounds like there might be another inquiry for Stiliana Nikolova. She scored 30.600. If you remember, went just one before Milena Baldessari. So she will have to wait for her scores, but she looks like she's enjoying every moment of it. So when we had the inquiry before, I started to talk a little bit about the Olympic Games and when the sport was introduced, and yeah, it seems to really have followed in the footsteps of the synchronized swimming as it was then back in 1984 with the individuals, and then groups added the same as the synchronized swimming, now artistic, back in 1996 in Atlanta. The crowd's really getting behind this. Medals for the Olympic Games for the all-around have been split across a few nations, really, with Canada, the Soviet Union Unified Team, Ukraine, Russia and Israel. Lenore Ashram just taking the gold ahead of Dina Avarina from the Russian Olympic Committee last year. And for groups, it's been Bulgaria, Russian Olympic Committee, Italy took the medals at the last Olympics. Ginnastica 31.0 is the score for Stellana. So again, that has increased as well. And a pretty quick turnaround there after the inquiry was put in. Good that they made a quick decision, having reviewed by video. 29.150, just slightly less than she got in qualifying because of that slight loss of the apparatus. Qualified second, Margarita Kolosov from Germany. This is her interpretation of Ninja. Well, lots of concentration there from Margarita Kolosov, depicting the music with her facial expression as well, which all helps to the artistry. Big hugs from the mascots. Really confident on the catches. So important that the trajectory of the flight of the apparatus is exactly right so they don't have to overreach. And things like the air conditioning and things like that can actually affect the flight of the apparatus in the air. But not too many problems with that today. 18 years of age from Potsdam, trains at the Fellbach Schmidden Training Center near Stuttgart 6 days a week, competed at the World Championships last year and took a gold at the World Cup in Tashkent earlier this year. Qualified second. So apparently the mascot is called Ape Andrea, which I'm not sure how I feel about that as my name's Andrea, but what it means is Andrea the Bee. So great name for a mascot, isn't it? Andrea the Bee, or Ape Andrea. Puts her in the bronze medal position at the moment, with one more still to come, which is Sofia Raffaele, who qualified first. Getting a rousing reception. So Sofia Raffaele from Italy, and this is her interpretation of Nemesis. Wow. She qualified first. 31.850 was her score. The crowd absolutely loved it. Such originality. So difficult. Some beautiful forward rolls in it. And the coach loved it too. So lovely when a performance comes off in front of a home crowd. 18 years of age, so only made her international debut last year. Started with artistic gymnastics and then moved to rhythmic. Fortunately for us, 4 years later. Already won multiple medals in the World Cup series and took the all around yesterday here in Pesaro. She seems to have really mastered every single piece of apparatus. Most of the rhythmic gymnasts have some kind of apparatus that they are would be their favorite. It's widely recognized that the ribbon is perhaps the hardest out of the four apparatus, but it's down to each individual, as Andrea the Bee takes a leisurely stance next to her as she rates her scores. 33.650. Absolutely beautiful. That puts her in the gold medal position. We just have to wait for the final confirmation of the rankings. But Sofia Raffaele, 33.650. Silver, Ekaterina Bedeneva. And a second medal to Stiliana Nikolaeva taking the bronze. Congratulations to all of them. Very fine margins. Margarita Kolosov just 0.1 outside of the medals. The next event on the program will be the five hoops final, and I was talking about trajectory in my commentary earlier on, and that is so important when it comes to the team events.